Hey everybody and welcome back to another Darkfall tutorial. So in this video we're going to be doing a kind of introduction to scripting for beginners. I mean, I'm still a beginner myself, but hopefully I can share with you guys some tips and things I've learned since I started scripting my add-on. So there'll be a link in the description if you want to check it out, but this is the blog about the add-on that I wrote. So yeah, I went from not knowing Blender Python or scripting in general to now where this add-on has around 5,000 downloads. And I'm always getting comments how people are finding it useful, so it's really good to hear. So the first thing we should do is set up our layout, so get comfortable with having our windows and things that we're going to need to script. And again, you can lay this out however you want, this is entirely up to you, but I'm going to show you a few windows that will help. The first thing I'm going to do is click up here and drag this down, just to split the window. Then if we go over here and change this window, I want to go over here to the scripting section, so we have three options. Let's go down to information, click this. So this info window will be very useful. It'll tell us a lot of information we'll need to know and things we want to find out. We can use this window here, so we will come back to this. Let's go back over here and this time split the window again, but this time split it this way. Then I'm going to click up here and change this to the text editor. Or if you feel more comfortable, you can have the text editor on the left and have the 3D view on this side. It's entirely up to you. And then down here, we don't need a timeline. We can change this to the Python console. Now this is great to test lines of code. Say for example you want to test something and make sure it works, then you can test it. So we may use this more in the future, but for now we can just move it out of the way. And then over here, this is where we're going to be working, this is where we're going to be writing the code. So before I do anything else, I just want to make sure we have these options enabled. So now we have everything set up, what I'm going to do is save this, go to File, Save As. Now this has been saved as a template, now I want to go to File, Save As again. So as I mentioned, this is for beginners. If you know scripting in general, then you'll probably have a better time understanding everything. So let's rename this script. I'm going to call this the add object script. And then for the extension, we need to put .py and then hit enter. Now we've renamed it. Let's go ahead and save it. So go to text and then go to save as. And then just navigate to a folder where you want to save this script to and then go ahead and save as. Now anytime that we write some code we need to make sure we go to text and then down to save, or you can press Alt S just to save it. So for this add-on it's going to be very basic, just to kind of introduce you guys into how it works. But I imagine you're watching this video because you have an idea of your own that you want to create. You want to create your own add-on, and some of the things that you see here might not apply to the things that you want to do. But having an understanding on how it works, because then we can change things and adapt it to make it work for you. For example, my add-on is in the compositor window, so it's nothing to do with the 3D view, and there was quite a few things that I had to change, and at first I didn't really understand it, but with help from the Blender community and also help from forums like Stack Exchange, I was able to get past the problems and obviously work through it. And then one more bit of help that Blender have provided is this template section here. So we can click on this, go to Python, and then we can select from one of these templates and it'll show us the script and how it works and how it's structured. And that's really useful. There's been a whole bunch of times that I've had to go and check out other lines of code and other scripts to see how they did it, to then implement it in my own. So if you do get stuck or you want to learn something different, and I think we'll actually go in here a little bit later on to find some stuff to use. So you can click one of those and load up the script and check it out. But I think we've wasted enough time already, so let's go ahead and just jump right into it. So on the very first line of code, I'm going to import BPY. This is going to import the Blender Python. So the first thing I want to do is create a panel. So when we go to the 3D view and then press N, we can add some options here on the panel. So let's go ahead and start doing that. So I'm going to type class. Then we need to name the panel. So for now, I'm just going to call it test panel. Then we need to open bracket. bpy.types.panel, close bracket, and then colon. Then if we hit enter, we can start defining some properties. Let's first do the label, so bl underscore label, then equals, and then give this a name. Now we're going to give this an ID name so we can identify it, so bl underscore ID name. Equals, and you can, and again you can call this anything you want, but I'm going to call it PT for panel type underscore test panel. Now we need to define which window this panel is going to be in. So for example, if we want it over here, or do we want it in the 3D view, or do we want it in the compositor view? Wherever you want this panel to be, we need to define now the space type. So BL underscore space underscore type equals, and as I mentioned, we need to know where we want to put this. So for example, we want to put it in the 3D view. If we just go to this window and then change it to something else, we can see up here in the information, it tells us what the space type is. So for example, this space type is view, but if we go back to the 3D viewport, we can see the space type is view underscore 3D. So we just need to type view underscore 3D. Now we need to define the region. So BL underscore region underscore type equals, and for this one it's UI, which is the end button here, so it's going to be somewhere here, and then hit enter one more time, and this is going to be BL underscore category equals, and we can place this in the tool section, so it'll be here. Or if you wanted to add your own tab, so add a new one here, we just create a new tab. Just call it something different, call it whatever you want. So now we've created a class, we've added some properties to give it some text, give it an identification name, and we've also told it where to sit on the screen. But there's nothing in it, so hit enter again. And now we need to type def draw, and then open bracket, we need to type self, comma, context, close bracket, colon, then hit enter. Now we need to type layout equals self dot layout, and now we can type row equals layout dot row, open and close brackets, and this will add like a space, so anytime we want to add a new space, we could just copy and paste this in. And then let's go ahead and add some text. So now anytime we want to add some text, we would type row dot label open bracket text equals, and then just type some text in here, so just a bit of sample text for now. And if we wanted to, we could also add an image equals, let's just give this a cube for now, I guess. And then we can close brackets. So within this panel, we're now telling it to do something. We're telling it to show some text. And again, we can add some more functions and actual things to it in a second. But to actually start seeing this work, we need to do one last thing. We need to register and unregister this panel. So I'm going to hit enter a few times and then go to the beginning of the line. And then for this, we need to define register. And then we could just copy this and then paste it. And this is going to be for the unregister. And in fact, there's a new way to register and unregister classes now, but this is the older way and it still works fine. I probably will upgrade to the newer, better way because it is better. But since this is the way I learned how to do it, I'm just going to show you this way, and probably in the future we'll upgrade to the better way. So you don't need to worry about it. We just need to register and unregister the class. Type bpy.utils dot register underscore class, then open bracket, close bracket, and then between these brackets you just need to type the name of the class. So I'm just going to go back here and then get rid of this space just because it looks nicer. Then I'm going to grab this text here and copy it, and I'm just going to paste it in between these brackets here. So this is now registering this panel, and then we need to just do the same just to unregister it. So we can copy this, and we just need to unregister it like that. And then finally, we just need to type if underscore underscore name underscore underscore equals equals. So it's quite a bit to remember, and I wrote this down, but I think in fact, if we go to templates, Python, if we go to one of these panels, I think you can just copy it from there. So you can always go back to the templates and copy and paste that in if you wanted to. It's entirely up to you. So now we have this, all we need to do now is run the script. So I'm just going to go over here, scroll through, and then hit run script. If everything works as it should, we should now see a new tab here. That's if you change this category to new tab. Again, we can change this to my first add-on and then hit run script. And now it says my first add-on. So now if we go to my first add-on, we should see some text, but I think, let me get rid of this icon here. Run the script and there we go, we see it now. So I'm not sure what happened there. Let's try that again. Icon equals, and then I'm going to find an icon. So by the way, I press Control T just to open up this sidebar here. Then I'm going to go to icon viewer, and you might not have this by default. You will need to go to your preferences. So edit, preferences, then in add-ons, type icon. So under development, just activate this. And then you will be able to see all the icons that Blender has. So for now, I'm just going to type cube. And then it gives me an option of all these different cubes. So let's say we like this one. I'm going to left click. And what that now has done is it's saved the name of it. So when I go back here, I'm going to press Control T just to close that panel. So for the icon here, I'm just going to paste in the name of it. So I knew it was cube. So I don't know why it didn't work the first time. I mean, I'm not sure why it didn't work. Maybe I added a space, or maybe actually I think, was it in lowercase? It possibly was. I'm pretty sure I typed it in lowercase before. Either way, now we have this. We have the cube and some sample text. Again, we can name this whatever we want. But still, it's just a bit of text with an image, so there's nothing going on. We need to add some functions to it. And as I mentioned at the start of the video, each one of you guys are going to have a different idea or a different thing that you want to achieve with Python. So I won't be able to cover everything in this one video, but hopefully I'll cover enough just to get you started. And we can always make more videos. If you've got any suggestions on what you want to see, go ahead and leave a comment below. So for this test add-on, we're going to make something very simple, and it's going to be an object adder, if that's a thing. I don't know. So let's go ahead and do it. Let's add some more functions to this. Let's say we want to add a button here to add a cube. And it's really simple to do. So let's just go to a new line. Again, we need to type row. And this is just to tell the panel how it's laid out, as you can probably guess with all these layout stuff. And there's a whole bunch of ways that we can lay things out. If you look through Blender and through the different panels and stuff, there's different columns and there's different rows, and you can align things to the left, the right, you can split things. There's a whole bunch of stuff that we can do to make things look pretty, but that's going to be a whole different tutorial because there's so much to cover in that. So we're just working with rows, and we might work with a column or so in the future, but for now, just going to try and keep it simple. A row dot, and it's going to be an operation, so we need to type operator. Then open bracket, quote, mesh dot primitive underscore cube underscore add, close quote, close bracket. So we run script, we can now say we have add cube. So as I mentioned before, we can see it's now sharing the same line. So let's grab this row equals layout dot row. As I mentioned, it's kind of like a space. We go here and then hit enter. And then paste this in. It's now going to add this to a new line, as we can see. I'm just going to press Control S to save the project file. And then if we go to text, save. Now we can test this out. Let's get rid of this default cube. Don't need it. And let's add a new cube. And it works. Simple as we thought it would. No matter where we move the 3D cursor to, it'll just add a cube. Very simple. So then let's say we want to add some more things. Let's say we want to add a sphere. All we need to do is copy this. So grab all this here, Control C to copy. Hit enter to go to a new line. Control V to paste it. And we just need to change literally one thing. We need to change it from a cube to something else. So now you might be thinking, how do we find the names? It's very simple. If we just Shift A, let's add in a UV sphere. Now, as soon as we do that, we can see at the top in the information, it tells us what it is. It's a UV underscore sphere. It's the exact same, except if we change this to UV underscore sphere, Then if we run script, now we can see we have the add UV sphere here. Again, let's make sure we add a bit of a space. So I'm going to copy this, just paste it here. And there we go. And now we can add a cube or add a sphere. We can make this look better if we go back here. And again, just as we did before, we can type icon equals. Obviously, this one would be a cube. And there we go. So we can add a cube, add a sphere. Now you can go through all these, go to your mesh and decide which objects that you want to add to your panel. Now I just want to add one more thing just to show you the difference. If we shift A, go to text, add in some text. We can see at the top here, it's almost the same, but it's actually a little bit different. So we can see instead of it being a mesh dot primitive, this is actually an object dot text. So all we need to do is type row dot operator, open bracket, quote object dot text underscore add quote close bracket. If we run the script now, we can see we have some text here. And again, we can add a new line if we want to keep things looking tidy. So that's a very basic introduction to scripting, I guess. We've now created our very first add-on. We've managed to create a panel within the 3D view, which we can now add a cube, we can add UV spheres, we can add fonts, we can add whatever we want. Now, if you wanted to make this work with your other add-ons, for example, if we go to preferences, and if I type Darkfall, we can see we've got my add-on here, and it works as a normal add-on does. We can remove it, we can install it from file. If you want to do that with your script, we will look at that in a future video. So I hope this introduction helps. If it did, be sure to give the video a like. If you guys have any suggestions on things you want to see, make sure you put in the comments below. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.